Oh no. I think we know who that is. Here we go. Sure about that? Try me. Oh boy. Oh no. These guys. Dark Gunners. And look who we have here. It's Geshep. Level 4 freeze. White dragons and cyclops. Oh. Yeah, this is not going to be easy. This area, by the way, is actually the best area to power level. Of course, that's after you defeat Geshep, of course. Now. I'm actually checking to see how many hit points Geshep has. Oh. That's not good. No. Yeah. I'm definitely gonna have to be careful here. Give a boost to man Jaha. One thing I will admit, one character you definitely want in your party for the last two battles is Zink. Now, the main reason why I'm not using him in these battles is mainly because of his low movement range. Same thing goes for Claude. The real reason why I'm not using Claude is because of his low hit points and movement range. Though, he's also weak against attack magic. So those are the reasons why I'm not using him. At least not right now. I might consider using him in the last few battles. The last two battles. Okay. Just gotta heal Slade. Okay. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. The Dark Gunners are gonna be a huge pain. When fighting them, I would take them out immediately. If you have any characters that actually have... If you have any spellcasters that use attack magic, use them. If not, then I would use long-range characters. If you can. Okay, I'll get rid of the Minotaur. And he's gone. Huh. Strange. Not sure what if Janet would have gotten an attack, but... Ow! Okay, at least he didn't attack Slade. Oh no! Not these things! You want to watch out for these things. These babies can explode when you hit them. Do not use close range fighters when fighting these things. Only use long range or attack magic. I'm pretty sure they can't. Oh boy. Yeah, they can move. Hold on a sec. Yeah, I gotta take out that Dark Gunner. Fast. No, not using, I'm not moving Luke. Well, not moving close, anyway. Okay. Watch this. Yeah. 60 defense. Not easy to defeat them. Alright, we got rid of one of the Dark Gunners. That's not good. And Gion's dead. Yeah. Yeah. That's what happens when you actually try to destroy these things. One thing I should warn you of, when fighting these things, never, and I mean never, keep your characters scrunched together. You saw what happened. I'm gonna get rid of the spellcasters first. The bishop and the wizard. Alright, get rid of the wizard first. He's a bigger threat. Alright, get rid of him. Should be able to get rid of the Mist Demon now. Okay. Now, get rid of the Bishop. Alright, got rid of him. To the white dragon. Ooh! Woo! That was nice. Got him! Alright, Screech. Damn. Wow. That did some damage there. Wow! Yeah. triple digits in hit points, MP, magic points, attack, defense, and agility without a boost. Now, I said multiple times that Karna was one of the most overpowered characters in gaming. I think that's enough proof. Yeah. Not a full heal, but I'll take what I can get. Now, there's one thing I want to show you. The last sound you can actually enter is this one, right here. The area you have to go to fight the last few battles is right over here. I would not go there yet. You'll find out why, if you dare. These guys again. Basically, what I would do, I would just ignore them. Let the enemies come to you. That's all you'll want to do. unfortunately, out of these enemies, I believe Geshup's the only one who can use magic. Okay. Yeah, I was right. Yeah, that's basically what happens when you destroy one of these things. They explode anyway. I just wanted to demonstrate. That's why I said to just ignore them. They're gonna explode anyway, even if you destroy them. Jaha and Slade. Can't reach Slade yet, so I'll heal Jaha. I need to level up. Screech. There we go. And I also need to get rid of that Dark Gunner. Do not go after Geshup first. I would get rid of all the other enemies first before you do so. Two interesting things I should actually mention. There is actually a Shining Force 3, though, no, actually not sure if it hit stores in the US, and there's also a semi-sequel to Shining Force called Shining Tears for the PS2. I happen to have a copy of it myself. Very good game. For any of you who are fans of RPGs and strategy games, I would...